Previously on Banks Built, we discussed engine bay and trans-tunnel layout with Sean from Empire Fab. Then Matt and Eric got busy staging the engine bay and cab. Now let's check in with a fabricator in his natural habitat.
Hey man, can you do some rust repair on my car? But I need you to leave the rust. But yeah, just fix the rust, but leave the rust.
Banks Built, protected by AMSOIL, with support from RoadsterShop and Nitto.
All right, so far what we've knocked out is we got the roof fully welded in. And you can see we got it all groomed, and that's all fit. And we ended up using a rust inhibitor inside the roof, and then we put new matting down for the insulation before we welded the roof skin on. Let's see, so far what we got is we've skinned out the rocker on the passenger side. We've replaced the floor that was rotted out from pretty much the kickboard down and grafted it in, sectioned somewhere right around in here. And then now we got our new pieces to replace the bottom of the A pillar. So we're gonna fit this piece and we gotta fit this piece in here, which replaces what is missing right here. And then on the other side, what we've done is the rocker isn't bad. There's a little bit of surface or rust here, but it's not structural, so we're leaving it since it is LokJaw. And so that's what we have done on the cab so far. And this last weekend, I was able to work on the Valance a little bit. I can show you that now. All right, so on the Valance, what we did is to get these gapped right, we ended up cutting them completely out and then flipping them from side to side. That way they were gapped perfectly. And then that lower scoop that used to be in here to feed air behind or to the bottom part of the radiator, we now cut all that out and remade the piece with the bead, and it goes all the way across. And then it actually flanges down underneath and has the bolt holes to bolt in like original now. All right, what do you got?
Well, I know you said you were going to start with the rockers and the floor this week. I'm sure you're working on that right now even. We were curious what your plan of attack was so we can kind of...
Okay, rockers and floor are going to be done tomorrow morning.
Okay.
And then I'm going to make a cardboard pattern for the firewall. And then my plan is to get the layout for the firewall and just get the sheet metal clecoed onto the firewall. And then from there, I was gonna do transmission tunnel and then driveline tunnel. Cause that's pretty much all I can do until we get the more stuff on the front end so I can do the engine bay.
Thanks, Sean.
Bye.
See ya.
All right, later.
All right.
Like, the sparks go one way. The only way the sparks are supposed to go are to f*** you. If the sparks aren't hitting you, you're cutting wrong. I need to drop and close this gap here. Yesterday I ended up finishing getting all the inner structure in here and the A pillar down all the way down to here, and we grafted it up here. Got that replaced, got everything fit again, refit the rocker, and then got the rocker fully welded on the passenger side. And then yesterday also we had the floor cut out of the driver's side. We repatched in what we needed to repatch for the rust over here. Did the side footwell panel, the floor, and then put in back the hat channel that we skinned out yesterday. And so now I got the go ahead. We're gonna go ahead and shave this gas door. Since the fuel cell is being moved to the back, it's no longer in the cab, we're gonna go ahead and delete this hole too. We're gonna go 20 gauge. This is a Dicom, and it's a layout fluid. And I use it to metal finish, I use it to lay out stuff, to scribe. So you'll see right now. Now that the gas door is done, I can move on to the next thing. Probably start fixing some fenders or make my firewall template. I don't know, we'll see how it goes tonight. So here's the current update. You guys were here yesterday, so this is where we left off. This morning we cut out the rest of the firewall and got it all situated and got it pretty much where we're gonna lay over the new one all the way back to the flange. We kind of straightened up the flange on the bottom. There were some different steps here, and we shaved a few of the other holes in the firewall, or I guess what would be the floor, just because they're not needed anymore. And if they need to throw any, they can punch them back. But we had to heat up this whole section over here and then hammer it all flat and take out the stampings that were factory in there. And then we kind of push this flange back a little bit. Now we have a straight line, so when we put our firewall in, it'll be straight all the way across. And as of right now, this is the firewall template. We just put the body back on, and I'm gonna get ready to bolt the body on and get it located. And then I can start fitting that firewall template onto here, do a final trim for the transmission tunnel. And then I gotta make a bracket that goes off the back of this that gives me the clearance for the intercooler fittings. And then that will set back how far the pocket for the motor needs to go back. So that's where we're at today. I've got to make this piece that we're just gonna break up. It's a 90, I'll punch some holes in it, and it's gonna bolt to the top of the intercooler, and that's to give clearance to the intercooler fittings that are gonna be on the back of the motor. Right now, I just have it traced up here. We're gonna need to cut that out so I can put that plate on there. That plate will bolt to this, kick back, and then go down. So whatever the back part of the firewall section needs to be recessed right to the back of that to clear the fittings on that intercooler. This is what they sent me, and that's the cover of their two fittings that are gonna come out of the back of that intercooler. All right, I'll trim the firewall again. I think what I'm gonna do is graft it right at, I'll probably split it probably right here. This would be the only structural thing. I mean, as long as the side is fine and we can get it in there, I might need to make this piece here on the bottom of the fender, because I don't know if the bottom of the fender will actually like be sitting on this correctly. Hey man, can you do some rust repair on my car? But I need you to leave the rust. But yeah, just fix the rust, but leave the rust. I'll groom it, and then we'll just do the same thing to the other one, and then we'll just, the rust is what it is.
In the next episode, Dale checks in with longtime friend Jonathan from Spark Industries. They're going to make some custom one-off wheels for LokJaw.